guys. My name is Brad. I'm the customer care manager at Banks. We just got our first Chevy Bolt, and so we just want to kind of take you around, show it to you. And as you know from prior videos, Tim Sattler, our product knowledge expert, GM product ninja, as it were, is here with us. And Angela from our customer care department, who is also very, very well versed in the Bolt, is here with us. So we're just going to kind of take a quick walk around it, kind of get you acclimated with it. You know, I obviously have questions about it. Angela's got questions. And Tim knows everything. So he's going to answer all those questions. And if you have any questions too, just put them in the comments, send us an email, and we'll be happy to answer them for you. We have this one. We've got a bunch of them that are going to be rolling in over the next couple of weeks. So definitely a nice car. So Tim, if you don't mind, just kind of like a quick overview. How long to charge this car? How do you charge the car? Does it take gasoline? You know, all those kinds of things.
All right. Well, great, good questions, Brad.
I want to come a little closer because it's a little bit loud in the showroom here.
The Chevy Bolt is all electric. So unlike our Volt, which will be electric and gas, this is only electric. And with a full charge, this car is rated to go 238 miles.
Yes.
So for a lot of people, that will meet their daily needs for commuting.
Thank you, sir.
All electric. Now, if you come around the other side, let me show you where you charge. There's three different ways you can charge this vehicle. 110, standard electrical outlet that you would have in your home. The problem with that is for 238 miles, that would take about 50 hours. So it's good to top off if you're down only a little bit, but it's not really practical for a driver who's going to do a lot of driving. The second way would be a 240 volt outlet that you could have installed in your home, and that would do a full charge in 9.5 hours. And that would typically be what a Bolt customer would have installed in their home. And then additionally, there's a third optional way to charge it, which is a DC fast charge, and that'll do a full charge in 4.5 hours. And that's something that you would find out at a commercial location where you could pay to have a quick charge done if you were on a trip or away from home.
Okay, so there's no gasoline in the car at all? It's completely electric?
Completely electric, no gasoline.
Okay, so if I just have, if I just want to plug this into my wall at home at night, when I get home from work, and have it ready to go the next morning, is that something that I can do? Tell me a little bit about what that would look like.
You could do that. You wouldn't be able to get a full charge overnight, but you may be able to get enough of a charge for whatever your driving needs are for the next day.
Okay. So for short commutes, there's no need to buy any additional equipment for short commutes.
Correct.
But if you want to be able to charge this thing up basically every night, 200 and how many miles did you say to the charge?
238 miles.
238 miles of the charge. So if you want to be able to get a nice full charge out of that every night, you need to have the actual 240 volt charging station.
Correct. Correct.
All right, perfect. How long does it take to go 0 to 60?
How long does it take to go 0 to 60?
He doesn't know.
He doesn't know.
I don't know.
Estimating is for most buyers, if you do 15,000 miles a year, you'll spend about $50 a month on electricity. And they convert that back to a car that gets 30 miles to the gallon. Well, again, if you drove 15,000 miles a year, that'd be a little over $115 a month in gasoline. So there's some significant savings with an electric. So people have questions about the battery life. The batteries in the Bolt, just like our Bolt, are warranted for 8 years or 100,000 miles. And General Motors is assuring us that the batteries will last that long and that the users won't see any significant reduction in range over time.
Okay. And so how much is it, how much roughly does it cost from an energy perspective to charge this up?
So a full charge using 13 cents a kilowatt hour, which would be a little bit high for what I pay at my house and you probably pay at your house. It would be about $9 for a full charge.
Okay. Roughly $9 for a full charge. Right. So that would give 230 miles worth of driving.
Correct.
For $9.
Correct. So you see that's pretty economical.
Yeah. Okay. That makes sense.
You've got a couple different ways of looking at the interface on the center console there.
Okay.
You can look at the status of charge.
Mm-hmm.
You can look at how the energy is being used, whether you're using it to propel the car or you're creating some energy using regenerative braking. You can see what percentage of your battery has been used to propel the car as compared to handle things like HVAC, comfort in the car. Obviously, on a really cold day, we're going to have to heat the car using some of that battery power, and that's going to lower the range. So there's several different modes that flow by.
All right, so this is telling me...
Right, that's telling you that right now, because we're not actually driving the car, you're just looking at a full battery pack.
Okay, gotcha.
And if you go over to your information screen,
okay,
and that will show you some history. Again, this is a brand new car, so it hasn't really had any mileage put on it.
Okay.
So there's probably not a lot of data there. And then if you go to energy settings, here you can set all kinds of parameters as far as where I want to charge, where my home charging location is, if I want to have it charge at certain times of the day because maybe I get a reduced rate for my electricity at night, which is not very common in New Hampshire, but in other states.
Okay.
You have control over many of those types of settings right here through this interface.
Okay. What is this location-based charging on and off?
So here I can set where my home is, and then I can tell it to charge based on the fact that I'm at home and the parameters I've set. So for example, if I leave my home at 7 o'clock in the morning, I can tell the charging system that I want it to be fully charged for 7 o'clock, and therefore I can delay the charging to later in the evening so that it charges right before I leave and I have a full charge when I leave. But I also can set the ambient temperature in the car I want when I leave in the morning. So rather than using my battery after I pull out of my driveway to heat the car up, I can have the car preheated for 7 o'clock and I can make those settings right here in the information center.
Okay. Now, this is going to sound like a really stupid question, but since there's no gasoline, this thing doesn't create any exhaust. Right?
Correct.
So it could be on in the building right now, and we wouldn't have to worry about any carbon monoxide.
Correct.
Is that true?
Correct.
Okay. We could actually turn this car on right now.
Yes.
And we don't have to worry about jeopardizing the health of any of these people.
Correct.
Are you sure?
Yes. The other thing to
is this
know,
on? Oh, that the up. Lights just went
on. Look at
out.
That. Oh, yeah.
It's telling me that the thing's open. Maybe it wasn't a stupid question after all.
Well, a Bolt
it
customer...
Was, you're laughing over there.
A Bolt customer may experience the car making noises when it's not turned on.
Okay.
For example, cooling fans, cooling circulation motors, and air conditioning compressors for battery cooling can all activate while the car is not turned on or not being used.
Okay. Let's see. What's this? Charge cord theft alert.
There is a mobile app for your smartphone.
Okay.
That you can download and have access to the car. And if someone were to unplug the car while it was charging, you would have the car signal back to you.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
Can you customize your home screen?
Here?
Yeah.
On the car? Absolutely.
What's this? Oh, look at that. Okay. Gotcha. And we got Apple CarPlay in here, right? It must be what that projection is.
Right. Apple CarPlay and Android Auto.
Okay. Anything else you can think of that we should hit? Button.
Let's step out of the car real quick.
I really want to know about the regenerative braking.
Regenerative braking? Good question.
Thank you.
Very important in an electric car. So the way the brakes work is when you first apply the brakes to slow down, rather than lose that kinetic energy with the hydraulic brakes like a normal car, where you'd be converting that energy to heat. We use the electric motor as a generator. We put a drag on the vehicle to slow it down and convert that kinetic energy into electricity so we can put a little charge back in the batteries. Now in a panic brake situation and you really stomp on the brake pedal, you do apply the mechanical brakes on the normal car. So you get the advantages of being able to recoup some of that energy most of the time, but in a panic situation it'll stop just like a normal car. Now to make regenerative braking even easier to use, there's a pedal or a handle on the back of the steering wheel. So you don't even have to use the brake pedal, you can actually activate the pedal on the back of the steering wheel.
Is that
and
just
that
on
will,
the bolt?
No, our bolt has
the
that
bolt
as well.
Has it too.
And you can put it into manual mode with the transmission selector, and it's called one pedal driving.
Okay.
So if you let off on the gas, the car will slow down. It won't coast.
Okay.
So you put your foot into the accelerator pedal to maintain speed or accelerate, and as you let up, the car will go into regenerative braking mode and slow the car down.
Okay.